eyes are receptive, my heart is open. My hands are receptive to.
Dressed in layers of clothes and with a winter jacket on. She also had a scarf over her head, labeled Knowledge. She enters the stage with a big duffel bag and a wallet in her hand. The duffel labeled My Cares and Burdens. The wallet clenched in her right hand. The wallet is labeled My Safety Zone. She also wears a gray hair under the scarf. The wallet has her checkbook and money in it. She has her cane with her. Her shoes is covering her tired feet.
I am tired of life. The problems of life have really weighed me down. I am only 45 years old, and my hair is gray. I don't even know why I'm here.
In her living room, listen to Pastor's message.
People of God, I just want to encourage you that the key to the blessings of God is giving. If you want God to bless you in the area of your finances, please obey the principles of God that is in the scriptures. The Bible says, give and it shall be given back unto you. Give measure, pressed down, shaking together, and running over. And the Bible also says that in the book of Malachi, chapter 3, verse number 10, that bring all the tithes and your offerings to the storehouse. It is a mandate from heaven. The Lord Jesus will bless you in return as you do this. We've done that this in our church many times, and even the church is being blessed through giving. Give, and it shall be given back unto you. Pay your tithes, obey God, and God will look out for you and bless you. God bless you as you listen. In Jesus' name, amen.
This pastor, he's very funny. I don't think he works. Because if he works, he wouldn't be asking people to bring their hard-earned money to bring it to the church. God does not need our money. It's the pastor that wants to get rich off the people. Nonsense. My money is my life. It is my protection and it's what keeps me safe. Get out of here, pastor. They come morning by morning, every day, always bothering me. Come in, you can come in, you can come in.
Why, ma'am, state your case.
There's a friend of yours who cares about you and wants to carry a burden for you.
What did you just say? Are you talking about this and this, everything that's on me, my burden? No one can take this burden from me. I am supposed to carry it. I am not a lazy person. I know my responsibility.
Jesus is your friend and he said he will carry it for you.
Go! You are thieves. You want to steal me? You want to steal all my livelihood? This is my livelihood. You want to steal it? Go! Oh, you're still standing here, right? Go!
What? Before I go, please take this. It's living water. You may need it in the future.
You need what to?
Living water.
Take your inferior water out of my sight. Now! Don't you know I don't just drink any type of water. I drink pure, filtered water. Thank you. I know my standard. Go. Go out of my house.
Put her hand inside her jacket
and brought out a paper labeled Stony Park.
I must accept everything they tell me this church today, because I'm tired of my life. Oh, hello, is this Kobe Cathedral?
Yes.
How may I help you?
Yes, I'm here to see if you have some of the living water. I hope you didn't run out.
Yes, yes, living water, I don't know, but is it here?
Is it fresh?
Is water fresh?
But is it juice?
Oh, living water.
Okay, let me go and call Pastor. There's this lady, she's in front of the door and she's asking for living water.
Good morning, my sister. I am told that you are here to buy the living water. We do not sell living water. It is free.
It is okay. I am a very self-sufficient person. I can provide for myself.
Jesus is the living water. I cannot sell him to you.
She's saying, where has this type of water been kept all this while? While she thought that her money could buy everything, she did not know she was poor with millions she had in the bank. She did not know that her food could not satisfy her hungry soul, nor can water fountain in her house quench her thirst. As she finished drinking the water, her eyes were open to see herself. She took off the jacket. The clothes along with the wig. Chaos.
Jesus into their life, come out. And anybody who has not yet surrendered their all to Jesus, come out. You see, Helen let her money and her burdens overcome her relationship with God. Your money, your knowledge, your degree cannot save you. Your children and your job cannot give you peace. You need Jesus accepted into your life today.